President, leaders on the dais, President of World Federation of Trade Union, Comrade Michael, and my brothers, sisters and comrades of Tamil Nadu, who has assembled in the open rally on the occasion of 16th conference of CITU in its golden jubilee year at the city of Chennai. At the outset, on behalf of CITU, we like to express our heartfelt gratitude and we like to greet you all for the support, physical, financial, material, all taken together. The support the toiling people of Tamil Nadu has extended to CITU to hold and host the 16th National Conference of CITU in Chennai from 23rd till today, in the presence of almost 2,000 delegates from all over the country, from all the states across the sector, and they deliberated on very crucial issue, not only on the lives and livelihoods of the working people, but for the people in general and for the country as a whole. And this conference has taken crucial decisions to fight against the barbarism and atrocities that is being launched on the present government at the center. And unfortunately, most unfortunately, those barbarous and atrocious governance is being cooperated and supported by the state government in the state of Tamil Nadu. They are an alliance. Country's working people are in the face of a very big challenge. And CITU conference deliberated on how to combat it more effectively. Comrade, please note, the conference has taken place in the background of a mammoth countrywide strike action by around 25 crore working people in India on 8 January, in which the working class of Tamil Nadu have shown their striking capacity magnificently. In that background, this conference is being held. With the warmth of the 8 January strike, which was not only by the working people, but by the peasantry and the people from all walks of life, students, youth, everybody came and supported this strike. In the warmth generated by that strike action, in that background this conference has taken place. You have helped us to hold that conference here. And definitely, to raise the temperature of our struggle, how to do it, we decided on those lines. We have decided our future strategies of complete, total, united struggle, not only of the working class, but of the entire people. And it is very notable, very crucial. It was really a point of something to rejoice Today we walked along the Mount Road, which was never allowed by the government. The CITU alone first ventured to carry a workers' procession on the heart of the city of Chennai. Government could not stop it ultimately. If thousands and thousands and thousands of workers take on the street, which government can stop it? So I think this public open session of 16th conference of CITU in Chennai has made a good beginning, because in the days to come, that attack is going to increase further. The rights of the workers are being sought to be taken away in the name of labor reform. Workers are fighting against that, and the struck work also, this is one of the demands. This government is trying to take away everything from them. They are imposing exploitation on them. People are losing job. Tamil Nadu is also a witness of that heavy job loss, particularly in the automobile and auto component sector. Industries are closing. And workers, when trying to defend themselves, defend their life, defend their family, then the most barbarous government is trying to take away their right to defend themselves, defend their life. One can say the right to life has been put on stake by this barbarous political force in the governance of the country, and being cooperated by the present government in the state. That's the scenario. This government is not only trying to impose brutal repression on the workers, whether in the organized sector or in the unorganized sector. Even in the government sector like Metro Rail, for just raising collective demands of the workers, workers are victimized, and you are fighting, CIT is fighting that battle. In the private sector, situation is much more horrible. But working class of Tamil Nadu has a glorious struggle tradition of fighting against those brutalities. I know our leader here, Comrade Sundar Rajan, was put on handcuff at the time of the struggle at Foxconn. But the struggle went on, and workers could defend themselves. In Hyundai, in Yamaha, there is glorious history of battle, and workers never surrendered. That's the tradition the state is having. And we are planning to go further with the rich tradition of the struggle, no surrender, and a determination to uproot. That is the spirit with which CITU has held their conference and decided their future strategy. I again express my gratitude, your support, wholehearted support, but without your support this would not have been possible. You did that. Again, I express my gratitude and thanks to these people of Tamil Nadu. This BJP government has put the country on the sale. They are selling out the country. When they think of privatizing railways, it is as good as selling the country. When they talk of privatizing the defense production industries, it is as good as privatizing, selling out the country. When they think about privatizing the pride of Tamil Nadu, the BHEL unit at Trichy, Ranipet, the Neyveli Lignite Corporation at Neyveli, they are selling out the country. They are selling out Air India. They are selling out our petroleum sector. Tamil Nadu had many installations of that. They are selling out everything in the country on which country is independently till now standing on her feet. And yet these barbarians are talking of nationalism, national pride, patriotism, all these things. Tamil Nadu people, they wanted to confuse them, misguide them, divert them. In the last Lok Sabha election, Tamil Nadu people replied to them effectively by isolating BJP from the people in a very big way. My red salute to the people of Tamil Nadu. But yet the entire country is in danger. We discuss in the conference. It is no use of convincing this government that this is bad for country. They cannot be convinced because they are, although elected by the votes of the people, are working for the foreign companies and foreign capitalists. That's why they can think of privatizing railways, defense, companies like BHEL, companies like Salem Steel, Neyveli, etc. So, the road, again, I must say that Tamil Nadu pioneered that road, and we discussed in our conference. They tried to sell out Salem Steel plant earlier also, and the workers, under the leadership of CITU Union at that time, has driven away the prospective purchaser from the plant gate, reached them up to railway station, and told them, next time if you come back, Jindal has came, come this time. Next time if you are seen nearby the plant, then you will be put on the railway track under the running train. They did not come back, dared to come back. Again, they have tried, and Salem Steel worker has created a history. They could not. No purchaser could yet dare to come forward to submit their bid. That is the impact of your struggle. Same thing was experimented, shown in Neyveli Lignite. For only 5% sale of shares, the Neyveli workers and the people at large went on strike, a weeks-long strike, and compelled the government to retreat. This is the history. We discussed in our conference. At this stage, we have to resist. It is no use. Word cannot convince them. And when word cannot convince them, something else has to be applied. In Hindi, there is a saying, "Latho ka bhoot, baaton mein nahi maante hai." To translate, those who cannot be convinced by words, logic, argument, they have to be tackled, they have to be given a lesson in the language they understand, and that is the language of resistance and struggle. In our conference, we discussed that we have already entered in that phase. In our conference, we have discussed workers are fighting with their trade union rights. If they want to snatch our trade union right by changing the laws, they have the number in parliament. We have decided we'll defy them. Let them pass the law banning the strike. The workers will spit on that law, and entire workers went on strike. What they will do by showing their law? That is the way those who can't be convinced by logic, that is the language That is the machinery by which they had to be tackled and given a lesson. Our conference, we discussed this and decided to prepare ourselves for that determined struggle in the days to come, not to allow these barbarians and the governance to sell out our dear country. That's the decision we have taken in these 4 days long conference in the deliberation, and we are confident with your support, the working class will be able to drive out these hoodlums in governance from the gate of the country. That's the only way open before us. Comrade, last point. Way before us to fight and fight more aggressively. At initial stage, the fight was on a protest stage. Don't do this, we are opposing. Now we cross that stage. We have to resist. We have to tell them we will not allow you to do this. And unity of the people is our biggest weapon. Unity of the workers, irrespective of religion, caste, creed, language, state, anything. Workers has got the only one identity. They are workers. They create value for the entire country. Workers create value by their labor, and rest are having a free lunch. Their employers and those employers, stooge politicians, are having a free lunch. It is the workers who create the value. It is the toiling people who feed the people, entire country. They are on the street, and their unity is their biggest weapon. That's why the ruling class and their barbarian agent at the governance are trying to spread poison in the society to divide the people on communal lines, on caste lines, on language lines. Worker of Tamil Nadu or workers of outside, migrant worker, on all these lines, they are trying to create division in the society. We have to fight against that. We have to fight their scheme of spreading poisons in the society to let one section of people against the other. And those who are spreading poison, they has to be tackled. They has to be tackled like a poisonous snake. And again, our unity is our biggest strength to fight, to put that poisonous snake under our feet and finish. That is the way before us. And in this game, now they are making a gravest experiment, dangerous experiment, in tearing apart our united country, tearing apart the integrity of the entire nation. The dangerous experiment of Citizenship Amendment Act, and followed from that, the National Population Register. They are aimed at creating an instability in the human society as a whole, so that the corporates, both foreign and domestic, can loot the country, can exploit the people, those who are creating value for the country. And remaining in an atmosphere of instability and uncertainty and discrimination, they don't fight against those crimes being committed on the nation, the loot and plunder. Working class has to be conscious, remain conscious about this poisonous game. We discussed in our conference. Again, here the same understanding must work. We are very clear. They have trampled underfoot our Constitution of India, which ensures equality of all people, irrespective of caste, creed, religion, etc. They are playing politics on that on Tamil Nadu soil. They take care of the entire people coming from the state to take care. They are telling that we are taking care of their interests who are persecuted by our neighboring countries. But they never mention the serious problems being faced by our neighboring country, the Sri Lankan Tamils. Here also they try to discriminate, divide, confuse and rule. We have to understand that. We have to fight against that. Our conference has decided we will not allow NPR to go. We have decided we will move to house and call upon the people, don't answer the NPR question, National Population Register, which is the first step to implement the Citizen Amendmentship Act. We called upon, from 1st April it will start. It is no use of arguing before these guys, because they are out to sell out the country, they are also equally out to ruin our nation, to destroy our integrity of our country. They are enemy of the country, enemy of the people. So, in our conference we discussed and decided the working class has to come forward. Throughout the country, again, that the protests are going on. We have to put all these protests towards channelizing in a particular goal that will not allow NPR to take off by our united intervention. We cannot allow this poisonous snake to poison our society. With this zeal, with this determination, we can save the country from being sold out, from being destroyed, their entire economy, because of the grave economic crisis. Country is going down the lane. Unfortunately, finance minister from this state, great Nirmala Sitharaman, and one after one step she is taking, it is the Modi government is taking, it is further putting the country's economy to ruin. In such a situation, to fight these barbarians at the gate, to destroy the country, to sell out the country and poison our society, to neutralize the resistance, this grave conspiracy, working class has to take up the baton, to unite the entire people and give a determined resistance to all this game plan. We have crossed one stage of struggle on 8 January. We are again preparing for next stage of struggle, a more offensive struggle, uniting with all the trade unions in the country. And we will definitely carry forward our struggle. Our conference has given a call, prepare for that more offensive struggle, heightened struggle, the struggle in the stage of resistance as well as defiance, and also struggle not to allow this poison to poison the society. In this two-pronged approach, CITU conference has decided its future plan along with other trade unions. We will plan for that, act on that, and we seek your cooperation. We people are determined we will be allowed to save our country from being sold out. We will be definitely successful in saving the country's economy from destruction. We will be successful in stopping this poisoning process of our society by these grave enemies of the nation. We have given a call for the strike against the anti-national policy of this Modi government and their cooperators in the state. We are again on the same call. We have to fight to defeat the enemies of the country, enemies of the people, enemies of the nation, and save our dear country and save our rights and livelihoods. We are again at a stage of resistance and defiance, and I am sure with your support we can go forward. Tamil Nadu has a very bright tradition of militant struggles. Many histories are written in the struggle on Foxconn, Hyundai, Yamaha, Salem, Naiveli. Many glorious struggles are written. We can march forward on that. With these few words, I thank you again for your support to our 16th conference. And we are determined and we are confident as well, we will be able to ultimately halt this disastrous, destructive exercise of the barbarians at the governance. We'll fight, we'll win. Thank you, comrade.